every day, billions of email messages are exchanged on internet. And nowadays, email has become an extremely popular, fast, and low-cost tools for communication. Have you ever wondered how email gets from your computers to your friend's computer? How protocols like SMTP, Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, send your email to your friends? And how your friends can access the email using protocols like IMAP, Internet Mail Access Protocol, or POP3, Post Office Protocol? To understand how email works completely, watch the video till the end. First email message was sent in 1971 by engineer Ray Tomlinson. Tomlinson's breakthrough was sent messages to other machines on the internet using @ to designate the receiving machine. An email message has always been nothing more than a simple text message. Even there is attachments sent to the recipients. To send the email, we are using email clients like Microsoft Outlook, Eudora, Outlook Express, etc., or any email services like Gmail or Yahoo. Use an email client that appears in a web page. Email clients generally does 4 things. It shows you a list of all of your message in your mailbox by displaying the message headers. The header shows you who sent the mail, the subject of the mail, and may also show the time and date of the message. Now you select a message header and read the body of email message. Other things that you can create a new message and send them. You type in the email address of recipient and the subject, like this is test email for the message, and then type the body like this email is for learning to how email works using SMTP, POP3 and IMAP in the message. You can add attachments also in the email. The email system consists of 2 different servers running on a server machine. One is called SMTP server on port 25. The SMTP server handles outgoing mails. The other is either a POP3 server on port number 110 or an IMAP server uses port 143. Both POP3 and IMAP handles incoming mails. Whenever you send an email, your email clients interact with the SMTP server to handle the sending. The SMTP server on your host may have conversations with other SMTP server to deliver the email. If I want to send a piece of email and my email ID is animatedstudyocean@gmail.com, and I want to send an email to other accounts like dr.jigar@yahoo.com, I am using a Gmail as a client to send the email. When I use my Gmail account and compose a message and press the send button, client connect to the SMTP server at smtp.gmail.com. Client has a conversations with the SMTP server telling the SMTP server the address of sender and recipients as well as the body of message. The SMTP server takes the two address dr.zeger@yahoo.com and breaks it into two parts, the recipient name dr.zeger and domain name yahoo.com. If the two address had been another user at gmail.com, the SMTP server would simply hand over the message to the POP3 server using a little program called the delivery agent. Since in our example, recipient is at domain like Yahoo, not Gmail, SMTP needs to communicate with Yahoo domain. The SMTP server has a conversations with domain name server or DNS for getting the IP address of SMTP server of yahoo.com. The DNS replies with the one or more IP addresses for the SMTP servers that Yahoo operates. The SMTP server at gmail.com connects with the SMTP server at Yahoo. It has the same simple text conversations that my email clients had with the SMTP server for Gmail. Now the message pass on to the Yahoo server. The Yahoo server recognizes that the domain name for dr.zeger is at Yahoo. So it hands the message to Yahoo's POP3 server, which puts the message in dr.zeger mailbox. If the SMTP server at Gmail cannot connect with the SMTP server at Yahoo, then the message goes into a queue. The SMTP server on most machines uses a program called SendMail to do the actual sending. SendMail will periodically try to resend the message in its queue. If there is some sort of problems like incorrect recipient address, most SendMail configurations give up and return the mail to you contains undelivered or delivery failure message. The SMTP server understands very simple text commands like hello, that's introduce yourself, mail from, specify the sender, RCPT2, specify the recipient, data, specifies the body of the message, RSET for the reset, quit is for quit the session, and help to get help on commands. Now to access the email, the simplest implementations of POP3, the server really does maintain a collections of text file, one for each email account. When a message arrives, the POP3 server simply appends it to the bottom of the recipient's file. When you check your email clients connect to the Yahoo POP3 server. The POP3 server requires an account name and password. Once you have logged in, the POP3 server opens your text file and allows you to access your emails. The POP3 server understands a very simple set of text commands like user to enter your user ID, pass for enter your password, quit for quit the POP3 server, list is for the list the messages and their size, RETR for retrieve a message, DELE for delete a message. Your email clients connect to the POP3 servers and issues a series of commands to bring copies of your email messages to your local machine. Generally, it will then delete the messages from the server. The limitations of POP3 protocol is once you download the email on one machine, then you cannot access to other machine. IMAP is a more advanced protocol that solves these problems. With IMAP, your mails stays on the email server. You can organize your mail into folders and all the folders live on server as well. When you search your email, the search occurs on the server machine rather than on your machine. This approach makes it extremely easy for you to access your email from any machine, and regardless of which machine you use, you have access to all of your mail in all of your folders. On the other hand, the limitations of IMAP server is you require internet connection to read the emails from server, or you required to cache the email in local machine. This is all about how email works. Thanks a lot. If you like this video, press like and subscribe the channel and share the video. And don't forget to press the bell icon for my new video notifications. Thanks for watching.